applause to the entire team who made this possible. This divine part too wouldn't have been possible because of without so many people who made it possible. We have an outstanding Toastmaster in this room who stood out of the room. Sure we are comfortable inside the room. I'm talking about the recession chair, plastic. Around the applause. Stay out and ensure that we are in is a huge achievement. Today, I thought I would like to talk about some people here. But before that, let me welcome, even at the end of this conference, our program quality director, DGM Atulajas. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Toastmaster, my hometown buddy, Pavas Chandra. Pavas. Division directors in this room, because I think I'm the only one standing here. Bansal had left for his marriage, you all know that. And my fellow area directors from Division I, Division E, whenever you are, raise your hands. Thank you so much for coming over and my beautiful friends. Today, when I come here, my speech was started in the first half, early in the morning. And where's Priya? Priya? You're not here. Okay. She asked me, sir, what is the title of his speech? I said, last minute. Last minute? Why didn't you come at the end? Appropriate for the title and the occasion. And that's how I got started right now. And I'm standing before you for the speech contest with us and this, right? But then, this last minute thing always bothers me. Raise your hands if you're wasted at the last minute. I know you're not raising, some of them are raising at the last minute only. I know 30-50% of people rested on last 3 days. Yeah? And the others who are early birds, raise your hands, first 3 days. Yeah? You have equal set of people. That last minute thing is very interesting. Last night, last minute, I was preparing my speech at 12 a.m. I was preparing for a presentation with the district director today morning, 8 a.m. Last minute, last hour. I thought I'll get all these letters, all these agendas, and all these participants print out last minute. And what happens? The printer doesn't work. So I prepared my speech, and my wife was almost sleepy. And I said, I have a 5 minute speech, can you please listen?
God.
I can keep her quiet, right? So she listened, and she could actually see me eye to eye. She was looking at the mobile and listening as well. At the end of 5 minutes, she said, it's very boring. A lot of gyan is there. That's what we do in Toastmasters, right? We don't give gyan. What's the difference? But I got a message. I changed my speech last minute. We all paid taxes last minute. Today is the last day for bibimbap taxes. Landlords, please raise your hand. Have you paid the taxes? I'm going to pay now. 12 a.m. before, hopefully, I'll get 5% rebate. Last minute, exams. Scribble. Last minute, we go and rush. Last minute, speech preparations. If you are a last-minute procrastinator, raise your hands. There are plenty of them. You know what? You know what? You're really good. You know what? Adam Grant said, people who procrastinate are original thinkers. Imagine, last minute, like, and that's history. So if the speaker's contestants are here, if you're making changes last minute, don't worry, you're in good hands. Last minute, original thinkers, how does it happen? Let me share an interesting thing. Agenda I forgot. Let me give an example. This is an agenda. I could get a printout, I put on my screensaver. Original thought, you do it, demo of this. Last minute, people are very creative. They are different. They keep changing. I was practicing my speech half minute, 10 minutes back for this session. But then the people who booked early, they were thinking, are we outside this last minute original thinkers? are we saying that, you know, we are not good? My wife would actually beat me up because she's actually precrastinator. She gets up at 5 every morning, goes and does all the household work, goes to gym at 6, 7, 7:20, she leaves, first one in the school. The last 6 years, every single day she has done it. And for me, I can sleep at whatever time, but I'll wake up at 7 because I have to go to office. Full predictability I have. And we are different and opposite poles. That's why we are together for 20 years. But then people who prepare, I have a good news for you as well, don't worry. Mr. Murthy, somebody here? No, Mr. Anar Narayana Murthy from the company I belong to, Infosys, said, opportunity comes to those who are prepared. Let me repeat, opportunity comes to those who are prepared. Let me give you two examples. One example, my manager, Sanjay Purohit, he's the CEO of Infosys Consulting. He said, Rajkumar, when I started my career, I was an industrial engineer. And what you know what the guys do? They stand in front of the lathe, they measure the time and motion study of that labor. Such a boring job. 2 years he did it on the shop floor. But then, he was preparing for his next role. He was preparing for a strategic role. And today, he's the CEO of the company. Let me take another example. Rajkumar Tekumala, Toastmaster at Infosys. He said, Rajkumar, I want to take up French. I want to learn French language. I said, Infosys is not even there, boss. We are in Germany, we are in Switzerland, France. Learn German, why French? No, I want to learn French. He learned, and 2 years down the line, we had a center in Mauritius. We need technical people with French knowledge. And voila, she got the job. Why? Because she was ready. It didn't fall in their lap because they were ready. So my dear friends who are predestinators, who are preparing well and planning well, that's what you should do. And the third thing I want to talk about, the third segment, is amongst his contestants. We have the second contestant. I'm sure they are waiting for me to end because they want to know the results. Tell this to them. That is very serious. Do what you want. Winning is not important. But methods to win are. Your goals, your dreams are very important. You have got to win to become a world champion. But the methods you adopt is very important. Because winners never cheat. Get that? Winners never cheat. And if you want to be a winner, either today or somewhere in your life, please remember that foundation of winning should not be on false terms. You know Ben Johnson? You know Lance Armstrong? You know Maria Sharapova? You know various cricketers other than them? What is common? They were great people, but they were cheats. They cheated you. You cheated us. And where are they? Disgraced. You might win the battle, but you will lose the war. My dear friends, you are here to win. I wish each and every contestant in this room wins. May not be possible, but you are a winner. You put in your best effort. You spent 110%. It doesn't matter who judges you at what parameters. You are one in your own right. If not today, somewhere, you will make a difference to yourself. On this August day, I'm so happy for all of us who are true winners in Toastmasters. Give a huge round of applause to each one of you. I have a dream. It was 10, 15 years back when we started. We were 12 clubs. You stood up. I'm stopping. I'm sorry. 12 clubs, we had a dream to get 100 clubs. That was a dream we achieved. When we reached 100, our desires grew. Can it become 500 clubs in the country? We are almost there. I have a dream to become 5,000 clubs in the country. Are you with me?
Yes.
Do you think it's possible in our lifetime?
Yes.
If yes, then we will make it happen. Thank you. Over to you, Master Sanjay.